plain and simple, we need to experience something beyond this world, experience something beyond our nervous system, actually. And we can do that. How do we do that? By saying, I let go of all conflicts unresolved, without resolving any of them. I let go of all conflicts without resolving any of them. I let go of the world exactly as I found it, without me accomplishing anything at all. As long as we are holding on to some idea of accomplishment here, we cannot enter that which is beyond this world, that which is beyond our nervous system, that which is untouched by what happens in this world. Because what is going to happen in this world, you don't want to experience, actually. You want to have access to something that is untouched by what is going to take place here in this world. We are coming into the very apex of troubles coming up this week May 20, was it 20th? It started the 20th, 21st, 22nd, oh, May 19th, let's say Sunday. And definitely there's a constellation of factors coming together. And so we need to realize we have access to that which is beyond this world, which is beyond the nervous system, what the nervous system can't even experience. And we have the access by being willing to set the world down just as it is. And if you want to say admit failure, but it's not really failure, but admitting that I didn't change it at all. It's still completely, all conflict is still completely unresolved and will always be so. So set all conflict down in an unresolved condition. And then at that point, you can enter into nirvana. You can enter into bliss. And whatever happens in the world doesn't matter. Because you're experiencing, you have access to experience something else that is untouched by the world. That is what we need right now. And that is, we are right at the door of that, at the door of nirvana. By looking at conflict and realizing that the idea of conflict must be conflictual. We cannot get rid of conflict from the idea of conflict. It's impossible. So we simply say, hey, okay, the idea of conflict is full of conflict. Fine. We're not going to keep trying to do something about that. Set it down and experience a non-conflictual idea. Experience how that feels. It's very, very simple. What is going to happen these days? Definitely something. The important thing is don't be in a hurry. Let whatever happens, happen. Don't go charging out in its way, as it were. Stay centered, stay calm. Don't be in a panic, don't be panicked, don't be pushed into something that is causes you to rush too much. Don't be in a hurry. Don't be in so much a hurry you forget nirvana, that which is beyond this world, beyond what our nervous system can experience, what the nervous system can experience is beyond it. It's beyond it. The nervous system cannot experience what's beyond it. But we can. We're beyond the nervous system. We're beyond the experiencing mode of this planet, of this density, of this of materiality. We're beyond that. But we have to be willing to let go of the world. Let go of the world. Let it go. And you may think, well, I haven't helped the world enough. Well, nobody has. Nobody has. The idea of conflict is always conflictual. Nobody helps it. Nobody helps it. We all, it's all pretense. It always will be conflictual. So we can just say, okay, I'm setting it down. I'm setting it down unresolved. I'm setting all conflict down unresolved. And that burden will drop away from us. So we can drop the burden that we're putting on ourselves. The burden of resolving conflicts. Cannot do it. Cannot do it. Let conflicts be conflicts. But what we're doing is we're experiencing that, beyond from a non-conflictual idea, which just simply means the idea of accepting reality as it is. That's it. So we're at this time now. I could speculate on what's going to happen. Very clearly, there are very dark events coming. And those are experienced in the world. And we need access to what is beyond. And experiencing beyond this world, we simply have to access it. And so we will do that. We will do that. We will now make the focused approach to this, and setting down all conflict, all conflict unresolved or not. Whether it's resolved or not makes no difference, and it's really not resolved. Setting down all unresolved conflict, all conflict as unresolved. It's unresolved. It's still conflict. We didn't fix it. We didn't heal it. We didn't fix it, and that's okay. We didn't feel it. We didn't fix it, and that's okay. I don't need to heal it. I don't need to fix it. I just need to set it down, and that's okay. That's what Ramana Maharshi did. He set down death. He said, okay, I want to experience what's beyond death. So let me just set down death and let death be death. I'm not going to change it, fix it, get rid of it. Let me just say, okay, I set death down unresolved, unfixed, unhealed. It is still death. And then he was able to go beyond it. And then he experienced the bliss beyond that, just like that. We can do the exact same thing, as a matter of fact. Exact same thing. Just set down the world as it is, not as you would have it be, not in any fixed or healed condition. Just set it down as it is. Set conflict down as conflict. And then that is how we go beyond it and experience that which is beyond. Beyond this world, beyond the realm of conflict, we can experience it. And then no matter what happens in the world, we still will be in blissful, centered condition, experiencing what is beyond conflict. So very simple. We can experience what is beyond conflict by setting conflict down as it is, as conflict. Not as something fixed, as conflict. Set it down as conflict. In other words, set it down as unresolved. Set the whole world down as unresolved. No resolution whatsoever. Set it all down as unresolved. And therefore, you don't have to worry about checking in with the world or not. You say, well, it's I set it down as unresolved, and that's fine with me. I don't need to check back and look at and see. Keep referencing it. Has it been fixed? Has it been fixed? It doesn't matter whether it's been fixed or not. I set it down as unresolved. That's okay with me. Just let it be what it is. So that way you're able to go beyond the world and not worry what the condition of the world is at all. If you don't even have any awareness of how it feels, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter because we say, well, if it's unresolved and it feels unresolved, that's not a problem. We're willing to let go of it in that condition. It's not some reflection on our failure at all. Not at all. In fact, just the opposite. We had the wisdom to see that the idea of conflict can never be conflict-free. It always will be conflictual. So we finally had the wisdom to grasp this and say, ah, there's nothing I can do about the world. Nothing I can do whatsoever. Nothing real. And so just accept that, and you're no longer struggling with it. You don't even have to, you know, be aware of it, so to speak, or experiencing it or feeling it. You can be aware of it in a spatial temporal sense, but it's feeling the impact of it. We don't have to. So before the impacts get to the earth, let us go beyond impact upon the earth. Let us realize that the earth has no impact on us anymore. Conflict has no more impact on us. We've gone beyond all impact. We've gone beyond it. We've accepted the unresolved as the unresolved. The unresolved is what? Conflict, of course. Conflict means that which is unresolved. So we are simply saying conflict is conflict. And that's it. nothing more needs to be said. Conflict is conflict. Let's just say it that way. Conflict is conflict. And turn away from it. That's it. Don't have to say anything more than that. Conflict is conflict. I set conflict down as conflict. I choose to experience non-conflict. So we are right on track, actually. And everybody's talking about what's going to happen now, because we're into it. And the foreshadowing is happening right and left now. The foreshadowing is happening. Always does. But we can say, conflict is conflict. I set it down as conflict. I turn away from it as conflict. I exchange it as conflict. That's what's called true humility. Jesus said the last will be first and the first will be last. The last, meaning those who have said, conflict is conflict. I can't do anything about it. There's nothing I can do about it. In other words, no accomplishment. The very last in accomplishment is the first. Whereas those who keep saying, no, I'm bringing peace to the world, I'm healing the world, I'm healing conflict, they'll be the last. They'll be the last. Those who say, I can do nothing, and I need not do anything. I can't do anything, I don't need to do anything with conflict. Conflict is conflict. The idea of conflict will always be the idea of conflict. It'll always be conflictual. Nothing anyone could do about it. Not even God can do anything about it. Ideas have their effects. That's reality. So the idea of conflict has the effects of conflict. So we just need to acknowledge this and say there's nothing we can do about it and nothing we need to do about it. Just exchange it for a non-conflictual idea. So this is the clarity we need for the moments right now as we go towards May 24th and May 25th. I think the 24th is a Friday, right? Yeah, the 24th, that's not going to be a very good day, I don't think, in terms of the world. Too much symbolism on that day. It's actually also the 55th day from the resurrection of Jesus in this calendar. Pentecost was Sunday, so Friday would be the 55th day, and 55 is a very significant day. The 24th being the 55th day. 7 4s on the 24th. It's just absolutely dripping with heavy symbology. It could be the day that we enter Nirvana, go beyond conflict. Again, go beyond that which can never be resolved. That which has no resolution, conflict, going beyond conflict. That could be the day that we decide, we're going to set conflict down as unresolved and turn away from it. That could be the day. Friday the 24th of May could very well be that day. And it could be a day for the augmentation of conflict, actually, where we see just conflict shows its face to us. And so at the same time, we decide to set conflict down. Say, okay, conflict. You are conflict. That's what you are. So I'm going to set you down, and I'm going to choose non-conflict. That's it. I'm not going to struggle with you. I'm not going to try to change you. I'm not going to try to heal you or try to make you better or fix you or get rid of you or anything. I'm just going to say, okay, conflict is conflict. And I set it down. Conflict is conflict, and I go beyond it. Conflict is conflict. I set the world down as unresolved. I set the world down as unresolved. Conflict is conflict. I set the world down as unresolved. And I wash my hands of it. I wash my hands of the unresolved conflict we call the world. I wash my hands. hands of the unresolved conflict we call the world. So we are going to do that for sure. And these times are pretty amazing. Very amazing, very wonderful if we take it in the right way, and we most certainly will. So with that, we'll wrap this up. Don't be a burden to yourself. Lighten the burden upon yourself. Lighten the burden upon yourself by accepting that setting down the world, washing your hands of the unresolved conflict we call the world. Lighten the burden upon yourself by washing your hands of the unresolved conflict we call the world, setting it down. Going beyond this world and you're experiencing, going beyond the nervous system and you're experiencing that which is untouched by conflict. Very simple. And we could just be a matter of days away from that. Days away from that. All right. Very great. Keep this one short. That's it.